were Leon and Eline from Holland.
Yeah.
And we, for 3 years now, we are trying to get a baby. And it hasn't happened yet. So, but we still try. In Holland, we tried various procedures with IVF and IUI.
Yeah.
An ICSI. But after 2-3 years of treatments, they told us all it's not possible for you anymore. Not in Holland, we can't do anything for you. So after that time, we decided to try a clinic in Germany to see if they can. Was with IVF. Unfortunately, they couldn't help us. Eh?
No.
So after that, we looked on the internet for other clinics in abroad. So we find a few clinics in Spain.
But maybe also, what is important is that we were advised to do egg cell donation, and that's not possible in the Netherlands, not for people like us.
Yeah.
Because there is a very
shortage
of eggs.
Yeah.
So we have to go outside the country, outside the Netherlands.
Go abroad, yeah.
Yeah.
Nina found a website with Paris clinics, also IVF Spain and egg donation friends.
Yeah.
And she saw that there was a competition, and she signed up for the competition, and
and
we won.
Yeah.
Lucky for us.
Yeah.
So we were already planning to go to Spain. This was a nice trip for us.
Yeah.
And after that, we had our first day at IVF Spain today.
Our intake.
We did some tests already, and we had a day of communication about all the procedures and. So far it's really good. Everybody's really relaxing, a nice atmosphere. You can talk in your own language. We've done more tests than we've done in Holland already.
And also there was a lot of time. The doctor has a lot of time.
Yeah.
She is very patient, and it was a really nice experience in compare of what we had in the Netherlands. In the Netherlands, the doctor is always in a rush, and the doctor has no time at all. If you want to have an appointment, then you have to schedule ahead, like I think 3 or 4 weeks, maybe much more. So, yeah, and if they have time, it's just 15 minutes. So, yeah, if you're here, it's really nice that they take time. There's somebody
It's guiding you all day, and it's a good atmosphere.
Yeah, very nice. Yeah, and very professional and really friendly people. Yeah, we are really happy that we've come here. Eh?
Yeah. We have known before that the treatment. In like for example in Spain are so professional and so well equipped and with all the tests and everything, it's we would have done it before.
Much so earlier.
My advice would be to look on the internet for various clinics and take your first intake and see for yourself how professional and how good the clinics are. Instead of waiting and doing all the procedures in Holland, which are not the same as the procedures abroad. But yeah, I would advise to go on a first day and see for yourself.
Yes, and what's also important is that to be aware of that the hospital in Holland work with different systems and different tests, or if they do test, they're not that modern as here. So they still use techniques which are not used here anymore. And here they have a lot of new techniques because it's a private clinic. So there is probably more money or more time in that way.
In Holland, you're part of a hospital. the IVF is part of a huge hospital system, and here is a clinic specialized in IVF and an egg cell donation and everything. So that's they do only this treatment, so yeah. they are specialized in this. What we see in what we saw in Holland is that you just undergo a standard procedure. They don't
see specific.
You as a one individual, but they just give you the standard procedure. And here you are. You have blood tests. You have.
You have blood tests in the Netherlands too.
Yeah, but it's more.
Specific.
More specific. Yeah. And not only blood tests, but more tests, and so it's broader. Yeah.